It is very fitting coming to you from London's National Gallery because Vincent himself actually visited this museum many times when he was living in London in his early 20s. And 50 years later, it was the National Gallery's purchase of the sunflowers in 1924 that was the event that really defined that Vincent had arrived as one of the great artists of the 19th century. There are seven Vincent van Goghs here, including a wheat filled with cypresses, which was actually the first Vincent landscape that we brought to animated life on our seven-year journey in making this film. But there is so much more in this collection than those seven paintings that relates to Vincent and also to our film. Henri Toulouse-Lautrec and Vincent studied together in Paris at the Atelier Cormon Art School. And Toulouse-Lautrec, all 4'10" of him, famously declared a duel in defense of Vincent, his dead friend. You'll see in our film that Toulouse-Lautrec makes a cameo appearance. Also making a cameo appearance in our film is the Mercurial Gauguin and Camille Pissarro. Elsewhere in this gallery, they have Delacroix's and Monticelli's, the two painters who most inspired Vincent in his radical new colour theory and his thick impasto. And in this room, we have Monet's. Vincent's younger brother Theo was actually the main dealer for Monet, and that is just some of the ways that the art and the artists in the National Gallery relate to Vincent. Vincent wanted to do for portraiture what Monet had already done for landscapes. In a letter written a month before he died, he stated, "I would like to paint portraits that appear as apparitions to people 100 years from now." These apparitions are at the heart of the film that you're about to see. In his very last letter, the letter found on Vincent after he died, he wrote, "We cannot speak other than by our paintings." We took him at his word, and we are bringing his paintings to life to speak for him. I hope you enjoy the film.
Your loving Vincent.